good day, welcome to Suni Art. This is Suni. Hello, 大家好，欢迎来到 Suni Art， 我是 Suni。 今天呢，想跟大家分享一个非常简单的作品，就是这件。这个创作呢，这件作品呢，其实是启发，就是受那个英国的这个 Podmillion 的这个启发来的。So this project is inspired by this Podmillion from UK 的 the pottery. OK， 它是一种陶瓷的一种用具啦，就是陶瓷做的那种厨房用具啊，碗啊、碟啊之类的。So it's inspired by this kitchen pottery, kitchenware. Okay, I show you the some of the picture. 可以给你看一下，分享一下你们它的原装的是它的。是这样子的 ，It's like this, okay? Original, okay? So a lot of us and a lot of friends in Malaysia actually they like this kind of kitchenware very much. 因为在我们马来西亚呢，很多友族的朋友呢非常喜欢这款厨具啦 ，okay? 所以呢，我今天呢就想跟大家分享这个是如何制作。坐在这个玻璃的罐子上。 So today I want to share with you how to make this one on a glass jar. Okay, this is glass jar. And the paper I special design, a special design in this, this measurement. Exactly is this, this size. 所以呢，这个呢，我们是另外在设计的这张图纸呢，就是设计了就是这一个的尺寸，这个罐子的尺寸。Okay, 我们用的呢是这个是水印纸，是非常简单使用的，不需要用任何的拼贴胶，也不需要用到哦，总之是不需要拼贴胶，工具都非常简单。And this one is a very very simple project that you no need to use any kind of glue or glaze medium. You use only this water slide paper. Okay, now I will teach you how to base coat on this glass bottle. 所以现在呢，我来跟你们分享如何我们要在这个玻璃上色。As you know, the glass is a non-porous surface. 你也知道这些玻璃呢，它是无孔表面。无孔表面呢，它你直接上色呢，它的颜色很容易掉，它附着力比较差。所以呢，我们还是要上一层这个万用底剂。Because this is non-porous surface, so if you just directly glue on, you apply the paint, after some time the paint will peel off. So it's not so stick on the surface. So the bestis using this multi-surface sealer from Heritage. I have been using so many different brands of the sealer and I found this brand is the best. Okay, to me is the best, okay? 我用了很多很多品牌的那个万用底剂，我觉得这个 Heritage 的牌子呢真的是最好最好用的。这个牌子呢就是美国那个彩绘大师 David 老师的产品。This brand is by the painting master,David Jensen's product, so I trust this product very, very much. 所以我非常对这个底剂呢很有信心。Okay, 所以其实你用的也不多，你用只是用一点点 ，and you don't use much. Actually, you use just a little. Okay, this is the new one. This is the new one. So you just take out this.Seal, 这只是新的，你就把这个撕起来就可以了。所以呢，我们只要倒一点就可以了。它干了过后呢，它是透明的。After dry, actually this one is the transparent effect. Okay, it's transparent. I mean, 干了过后呢，你只是这样子把它涂上去就可以了。干了过后呢，它是透明的，而且最重要呢，它不需要等24小时。干了过后呢，你就直接可以上色。And most important is that this sealer is very good that after it dry, you can immediately apply the color. That's all. Okay, just like that. It's very simple. You see, still have a lot here. 所以你看我只是涂了。这样子我还有很多，所以你基本上你是用很省的。Basically, it really safe. Okay, so I blow dry and we continue.Okay, after blow dry already, as you can see, it's transparent. 吹干了过后呢，其实它就是透明的。你看你刮呢，其实都是没有痕的。You can also scratch, you can see the sealer is really go into the bottle already. 你也可以看到那个，它非常的附着力，非常的强。你刮它也是不会掉的。Okay, 就是不需要等一天 ，no need to wait for 24 hours. Then now we use a dauber to dab the soft white color. You can directly apply the color. So I like to use Sunny Arts acrylic paint, because Sunny Arts acrylic paint we have added some sealer into it. 所以我也喜欢用 Sunny Art 的颜料，因为 Sunny Art 的颜料呢，其实也是加了一点底剂进来。所以呢，我要用到的呢就是那个海绵棒。就我们就大概呢会拍两三层到它饱和。So we will dab few layers until it's all big, okay? Just dab like this.饱和，不需要很厚，每一层呢薄薄一层一层铺上去，不要一下太厚。So no need to be very thick, you can do many layers, but a thin layer. Okay, I like to use a double so you won't dirty your hand. 我喜欢用海绵棒这样子呢，你当然你也可以用普通的海绵，只是普通的海绵可能会把你的弄到你的手很肮脏，这样子就 okay. Like this one is one layer, so you need to do at least 2 to 3 layer make it all pick, okay? 所以大概你要做两三层，让它呢是不会看到底色的，就是让它是饱和的颜色。然后这里呢，你要把它擦干净。So here you can clean it with the damp cloth, okay? 你就用湿布把它清理干净就 okay 了。所以我们先把它吹干。Okay, blow dry already, you can do apply second layer. Now you can choose to use the brush or you can still continue using the dauber. 吹干了过后呢，你可以选择呢用笔刷来上色，或者你还是可以用回你这支海绵棒。第一层呢，我就是一定会用海绵棒来拍颜色上去，因为呢这样子呢它的颜色比较容易可以吃进去。For the first layer, I would like to use a dauber or sponge because the color will really go into the bottle. But the second layer, I like to use a brush. You know why? So you won't see a lot of texture. Okay. 第二层过后呢，我通常呢，我都会喜欢用笔刷，这样子呢，就不会看到很多海绵的那个质感，一粒一粒颗粒的质感。So you also can choose to use brush. It will be much smooth on the second layer or onwards. Okay. So, but it depends on you. 但是都是随性自由的，你要用笔刷也可以。第二层你要接续用那个海绵也 OK。So as you can see, after second layer is still not all big.It's not so opaque, so I will try to put the second layer. 所以你看了两层过后呢，其实它也还不是很饱和，所以呢，我可以有第三次，我可以用笔刷。So I will try to use the brush. You will see it's much smooth and more even. 你可以看到呢，它其实是更加饱和而且更加柔和就不有很多那个海绵所产生的质感，而且呢，颜色呢就比较可以均匀。所以就大概三层就 OK 了 So it's around 3 layers will do So blow dry, then we continue the second another step 然后把它吹干，然后我们就再接续下一个步骤就 OK 了 So after dry, the next step is we have to apply this water-based varnish 所以吹干了过后呢，我们就要上大概两层的那个亮光保护剂最很重要我们上这层亮光保护剂 This step of varnish is very important because the water slide paper actually you use the water so this varnish is to protect the paper going into the paint 所以呢这层非常重要因为呢我们是做水转印纸嘛水转印呢然后它就不容易伤害你的素材因为你已经用那个亮光剂好好的保护了 OK 就大概涂两层吹干然后我们就接续 Just two now blow dry another layer then we continueOkay, now we can cut out the paper. 所以我们现在呢把纸张剪出来。这个图纸呢一共有六款。So in this paper, you can see, we have total of 6 designs. So you can make 6 bottles. 所以你可以做六个瓶子。这个多出来的呢，其实呢，你就可以，你也可以这样子在这里上色一样的技法。You also can color the whole bottle.Same technique, okay? So you can design your own design. You can use this strip here to put here, okay? 你也可以把自己设计，可以把这个线呢把它粘在这里 okay? 就是拉一圈不够呢，你可以把它接过去。If not enough, you can actually connect with another line. Here you can put another flower. 这边呢，你就可以把纸，你就可以把花剪出来。You can cut out all this flower and you put here. So later I will share with you also. 等下呢，我也可以分享给大家看。所以呢，现在呢，我们就把纸张先剪出来。我就想要这个 ，So I want to use this one. So try to cut closer. Don't leave too much of the white. 尽量呢就剪近一点，不要留这么多白色的空白。 OK， 就是这样子把它先剪出来。So this is a very very simple project and look very nice also. 这个呢是一件非常非常简单的作品，而且呢也很好看，可以拿来呢可以拿来送礼啊，然后里面呢可以放一些自己做的饼干， then also you can make some cookie and also as a gift for your friends. 然后呢我们之前把铺牌， see this one is roughly is the position. Okay, fix the position first.Take the water， 就拿一些水，然后呢海绵 ，then the normal sponge， OK， 就泡湿海绵，这样子把它把水弄湿海绵，然后把它这样子涂上去。So just wet the sponge and just apply on top， 就是来的，就是蛮简单的。所以水可以多一点 ，you can have slightly more water。Then you see, is it stick on already? 然后你再看看，哎，已经是粘上去了，就是这样子把它从一边拉出来就 OK 了。Just like that, you see, very simple and nice. 这很简单的，这样子就大概要完成了。所以呢，这边里面还有一些气泡 ，actually they have some bubble and air inside. So what you need to do is simple. You just need a needle. 所以你需要的呢，就是一支针。Okay, a needle. Just poke some hole here and there. 就是在一些地方，就是局部的一些地方呢，你给它插一点洞，就是这样子让它的气泡有地方出来。So just make the bubble have some place to go out. Okay. And use only your finger to make it even. 就是这样子用手呢把它推平， just even with.Also smooth out the extra wrinkles and the bubble using your finger, just like that. So if you still have wrinkle, a bubble, you just poke the hole. 如果你觉得还有气泡在里面呢，你就是这样子把它插一些洞就可以了。然后呢，拿一个干的纸巾 ，then use a wet the dry cloth, just dab away the extra water. 然后只是这样子压就可以了，把多余的那个水分呢吸干。Okay, just dab away the extra water. You see, now like this already done. It's very simple. It's very very simple and nice. 其实是非常非常简单的。当然，这些空白的地方呢，我们还有那个，还有很多的蝴蝶，你也可以把蝴蝶剪过来。If you see that empty part here, you still can cut the butterfly.It's up to you. You want to cut some butterfly and put here. It's always up to you. Okay, it's your own design. 就是你自己的创作，你自己喜欢，这样子就大概 OK 了。Okay, then, blow dry first. 先把它吹干，先吹干，然后呢，我们就上多大概三层的亮光保护剂就完成了。After blow dry, we apply around 3 layers of this water-based varnish. Then, completed. Okay, so I blow dry first.就完全完成了，是一个非常非常简单的作品。 So it's a very simple project that you can try at home. Okay, and not much of material required. 而且呢，真的不需要很多的材料也就可以完成了。 Okay, so just apply 3 layers, 就是这样子就完成了。 Okay, 所以呢，就每一层吹干了过后呢，你就涂上第二层、第三层。So every layer you blow dry and apply the third and the fourth layer. Okay, now so this one already done. Now I share you this one. 所以呢，我现在来分享你们做这个。我就把这个线条呢先剪出来。So I will cut out this line first. Okay, cut out this line first. 把这个线条先剪出来。Okay, this one already cut out, and you measure. 把它剪着出来过后呢，你就要再量一下 它的尺寸 ，OK， so it's until here， so I will cut here， 就把它大概到这里，就把这里先剪出来。So cut out this one. So it's the same method. Just put on here and put the water with the sponge. 然后呢，你就用那个海绵沾水呢，先把它慢慢铺上去。Okay, it's the same. The water and the sponge. Okay, 就是一样的，这样子把它铺上来。Water, or else it's hard to stick. 你要足够的水。这里呢也是一样，我已经有涂了两层的亮光保护剂，不然这边呢它就水分呢就可能会渗透，然后它就没有这么好看。 So I here also I already varnished two layers to protect the surface. 不是说不好看，就是先我要把这个我们已经涂好了的素材这个胚体呢先上一层保护剂把它保护 OK， 然后把它撕上来就 OK 了。 See? Just like that, done, done.So adjust, okay, see, like that. Then also dab away the extra water with a dry cloth or kitchen towel. 然后呢，你就用那个干的纸巾呢，把那个多余的水分吸干。Just like that, okay? See.Okay, so after blow dry, you have to varnish few layers or so. 吹干了过后呢，也是一样，你就上多层的几层的亮光保护剂。Okay, 然后呢，现在呢，我们来做的呢，就是这里。Then here, if you have the extra paper, you no need to use the strip here. You can cut only the flower. 所以这里有剩下的纸呢，我们不要剪坏。This one you don't cut. You have to cut nicely because later maybe you need to use or so. 这里呢，你不要把它剪坏，可能你等一下还可以用。我们就把里面的花剪出来。So we just cut out the flower. We need only the flower.我们只需要那个花，然后呢也是一样 try to cut close， 尽量呢把它剪靠近，不要留这么多白。 So cut, try to cut close and don't leave so much of a white color. Okay, actually I have another paper design that only with the flower, so without this. 其实我还有另外一张纸的设计呢是没有这个圆圈的，只是花。你也可以选择用那张纸的花来做这里 ，OK， 而且也比较大。And also the paper is much bigger, OK, the flower is bigger. 那个纸呢，它的那个我的那个花呢也比较大，比较适合这个玻璃 ，is much more matching with this glass because the flower I arrange much bigger, OK, it's exactly this size. 那个我设计的呢是大概是这么大的，所以是比较适合。Then Okay, you also can do like this, or you can soak into the water. 你有两个做法，你也可以把纸泡在水里面，你也可以这样子做，都可以。So two way of doing this one is up to you. Which way is you found convenient? 两个方式都可以，就是看你适合你喜欢哪一个方式，这样。然后再移动一下，看一下，哎，还不行，所以就是水分还不够。So when you move that the paper still stick is not separated, means the water is not enough. So you have to wait for a while. Okay. Okay. Then.就是把多余的水分吸干，你看这样子就完成了。Like that already done. Okay, so a very simple project. Hope you enjoy my tutorial today. 是一个很简单的作品，希望你喜欢我今天的分享哦。可以给我一个赞，或者是欢迎分享。You can give me a like or you can share with your friends. Thank you for watching. 感恩收看。